Yan. So dito naman, locate the centroid of the shaded area. Now, ito, medyo mahirap kasi kailangan talaga ng integration. Hindi kasi composite yung figures or hindi common din. So, para sa area, para ma-review lang din natin yung integration, concept ng integration, let's try to solve the area using a vertical strip and a horizontal strip. But sa centroids, yung ano na lang, yung mas ideal na lang na strip yung gagamitin natin. So for this problem, we have two options to solve the area. But upon inspection, yung mas madali na ang tawag dito na strip would be a horizontal strip, which is ito. Now, explain ko mamaya bakit. So, if we have a horizontal strip, then we have a differential height dy. Yan. And then, this is the right x value. So, label natin as xr. And then, ito naman, itong point na to, this is xl, or the left x value. Now, mas maganda yung horizontal strip kasi xr or the right x value is constantly defined by this line. Yan. Which is also defined by this equation, x squared equals 40y. And then, yung x na nasa left is always itong y-axis. So, constant yung xr saka xl. So, we can just form one equation to solve the area. So, kaya, mas madali. Yan. Now, if we have dy, parang yung area natin would be this length, yan, multiplied by dy. Yan yung area ng isang strip. But, essentially kasi, i-add kasi natin yan lahat. Hindi lang kasi isa yan pag nag-integrate ka na. Parang meron ka ng infinite strips, parang ganyan. Tas i-join mo yan lahat. Yan, pag i-add mo yan lahat, makukuha mo yung area. So remove ko na lang. Yan. Yan basically yung concept natin. And then since we have dy, dapat yung limits natin are defined by y values. Yan yung isang consideration natin. So, the area of this figure pala is parang the integral from a to b of xr minus xl multiplied by dy. Yan. This is essentially a rectangular element. Parang area lang ng rectangle. So, oh, wait lang. Ah, yan pala. So, A would be the lower limit. So, the lower limit is, since hindi yan kasali, ito, hindi yan kasali, ito pala yung lower y limit natin, which is 25 mm. So, integrate pala tayo from 25. And then, our upper limit naman is this point, which is 25 plus 65. So, diba, total niyan is 90. Yan. And then, XR minus XL naman, ano yung XR? We first have to define the function in terms of x talaga. Not in terms of x, in terms of y. So, we can redefine this as parang tama, sorry. In terms of x, yan. So, we can get the square root of both sides. So, magiging square root of 40y. Yan. Sorry. Horizontal strip pala tayo. Yan. So, yung xr natin, square root of 40y. Now, how about xl? Diba, yung x left natin, would be the y-axis for which the value of x is 0. So, parang square root of 40y minus 0 yan. And then multiplied by dy. So, taking the area, we have from 25 to 90 square root of 40y. Yan. So, this is 3072.95 mm squared. Now, how about if we are to choose a vertical strip? Ito yung mangyayari. Copy ko na lang ulit. And what if vertical strip? If vertical strip tayo, let's say, eto. So, this is dx. And then, ito naman, ito yung y upper, yu, and ito naman yung y lower. So, itong distance na to, yan, yung height niya is yu minus yl. Parang ito lang. Yung length niya is xr minus xl. Pero, medyo mahirap pag vertical strip. Bakit? At these points kasi, let's make a point here and then extend tayo ng line. Yan. Para sa region na to, yu is constantly 90. Kasi diba, 90 yung y dito. 65 plus 25. 90, always 90. And then, yung yl naman is always 25. Diba? But, sa region na to, yan, yung region na yan, it has, yung y upper is still 90, but y lower is now defined by the points sa line na to. So, essentially pala, we have to divide this, parang split natin into two figures. So, para sa region na to, after this line, yan, ito yung strip natin. So, this is dx. Ito naman yung y upper. Ito yung y lower. And this is yu minus yl. So, we have to separate the limits then. Meron tayong limits for this region. Yan. And we have another set of limits para sa region na to. And so, isosolve natin yan. Now, x squared daw is 40y. Now, when y is 25, ano yung value ng x? Lagay ko na lang. Para dito, when y equals 25, x equals what? Diba, we have defined this as x equals square root of 40y. Pagkunin natin yung square root ng dalawang sides. So, when y is 25, 40 times 25. Yan, we have 10 square root of 10. Yan. So, the value of x pala at this particular point is 10 square root of 10. And then, how about dito sa top part? When y equals 90, ano yung x? So, ito pa rin yung gagamitin natin. Yan. But instead of 25, papalitan natin ng 90 yung y. Now, 40 times 90 is 360. Square root niyan is 60. Diba? Now, or, i-type na lang natin. Yan, so 60. So, ito yung gagawin natin. To solve the area, first, we have this region. From dx kasi yan, so dapat x values. Now, x here is, diba, 0. Yan. So, from 0 up to 10 square root of 10, we have iba yung yu sa kyl natin. I mean, yung yu, the same lang, but yl differs. So, yu here is, ano yan, 90 minus yl. yl is 25. Yan, 25 kasi yung height dyan. So, yu minus yl, and then dx. Limits natin from 0 up to 10 square root of 10. Yan. And then, we have to add another set of integral, which is from 10 square root of 10 up to, ano yan, x equals 60. Lagay ko pala. Yan. So, 10 square root of 10 up to 60. And then, yu minus yl will now be 90 pa rin yung y upper natin, but yl is now defined by this one. Now, we can rearrange the function. Divide natin by 40 yung dalawang side. So, we have y equals x squared divided by 40. Now, ito yung y lower natin, defined by this line. So, 90 minus x squared over 40 pala. Yan. And then, meron tayong dx. So, add natin yung dalawa. Square root of from 0 to 10 square root of 10. Then, 90 minus 25. And then, plus integral from 10 square root of 10 up to 60. Yan. And then 90 minus x squared over 40. Yan. So press equals. We can still get the same area. Exact talaga. Diba? 3072. Yan. 0.953723. So, the same lang. But, mas mahirap yung vertical strip. Yan. So, since alam na natin na mas mahirap yung vertical strip, wag na lang natin pahirapan yung mga sarili natin sa centroids. Sa centroids, yung gagamitin na lang natin, yung horizontal strip na lang. So, paano i-calculate yung centroid? We still have to use Verignon's theorem. Now, diba, sa theorem niya, we have the resultant, or pwede yan area, pwede yan length ng line, or force, mga ganon. Multiply natin by barred x or barred y, depende sa ano yung hinahanap mo. Multiply natin by the summation of each area. Ano na lang? Area total na lang to. Yan. Sum up natin lahat ng areas multiplied by their respective moment arms going to the reference line. So, we have barred x n. Ano na lang? An barred x n. Now, alam natin yung area. We have this value. Yan. And then, let's first solve barred x lang. Yan, barred x. So, to sum up the product of the area and the moment arms, we have to apply integration. So, looking at this strip, yan, diba, this is a rectangular strip. Yung centroid niya, andito sa gitna. Orange na lang. Andyan sa gitna. Now, what, yung reference axis pala dito would be the x-axis and also the y-axis. So, lagay na lang natin. Reference axis. Ito rin. Yan. So, from the reference axis, ano yung distance ng centroid patungo dyan? Diba? It will be this distance. Which is half of XR minus XL kasi this is rectangular. So, XR pala to. Medyo hindi friendly yung color. Ito na lang. Yan, this is XR minus XL divided by 2. I hope you would agree. Yan. And then, ano naman yung distance ng centroid patungo sa reference axis na x-axis? Diba, we have this distance naman. Yan. Now, since nagsa-start yan sa origin, yung distance pala na yan, that's y. So, lagay natin. Y. So, first, for barred x pala, we have to integrate from yung limit natin, the same dito sa area, from 25 to 90. Yan. And then, area natin naman is ito, xr minus xl dy, or this expression. Ito yung area. But we have to multiply this by the moment arm. Now, the moment arm, if we are to solve barred x, diba, ito man yan. So, magiging xr minus xl divided by 2. So, xr natin, still square root of 40 multiplied by y, minus 0, or pwede mo yung i-omit, and then divided by 2. Yan. But again, sa calculator, hindi mo siya ma-input in this manner. Kasi yung dy dapat nasa huli. So, just multiply this sa expression na to. And then, default kasi ang dy. So, lagay natin. Square root of, integral from 25 to 90. Then, square root of 40y for this expression. And then, multiplied by square root of 40y divided by 2. Yan. Yan. So, press equals, magiging 74750. And then, pwede natin siyang i-copy. Ito. And then, dividing both sides by this value, then x bar is 74750 divided by 3072.953723. So 24.325. Yan. So, ito pala yung distance from the y-axis para sa barred x. Minimize natin. Yan. And then, for ano naman, tama na to, 24.33. For 60.69 naman, kailangan natin yung centroid nito. Yan, or isosolve natin yung barred y, essentially. So, copy lang din natin to. Yan. And then our limits would be from still from 25 to 90. And then this is still our area. But, yung moment arm natin, this defines the area from the reference axis. The distance patungo sa centroid ng figure is y. So we have to multiply this by y lang. Yan. So input natin. Yan, balik tayo dito. Ito lang yung na-change. Square root of 40y multiplied by y, so times x, then dx. So 186494.3058. I mean 186 pala. Sorry. And then, by the way, this is barred y na pala. So, solving barred y, we have this value divided by the area. So, magiging 60.69. Yan.